Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. In this session we will see how to find out the sum of all n digit numbers where zeros are included. To move forward with that, let's recap what we learned in the last session related to this particular topic. We learned that sum of all n digit numbers non-zero is given by n minus 1 factorial into sum of all digits into 1, 1, 1, like that we have to write for n times. So what we understood, let me just try to take one example and just explain that again. We have understood that suppose I have been given numbers 1, 2, comma 3. I have to find out sum of all 3 digit numbers. Sum of 3 digit numbers, because 1, 2, 3 we are taking all the 3 digits. Please remember this, because we are going to generalize this formula at the end of this particular session. Sum of 3 digits we want to find out by using 1, 2, 3. Then our formula is here n equal to 3, therefore n minus 1 equal to 2. So it is factorial 2, n minus 1 factorial into sum of all digits, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 into 1, 1, n times. N times is 3 times, that's nothing but, which is equal to 2 into 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6 into 1, 1, 1. That's equal to 1, 1, 1 into 12. That's equal to 1, 3, 3, 2. So this example we have done in the last session. We understood how to do that. Now our criteria in this particular session to understand is, now suppose instead of 1 I have 0, or instead of 2 I have 0, that means one of the term becomes a 0, then how many n digit numbers I can have? Let's try to understand that. But this is the formula. We will see how the formula is derived now. The formula says that sum of all n digit numbers including zeros is equal to whatever we got earlier, n minus 1 into sum of all digits into 1, 1, 1, n times minus of. We know that whenever we start with 0, it won't be that digit number. You want 3 digit numbers? First digit is 0, it becomes 2 digit number. So we have to subtract all the 2 digit numbers which are starting with 0. So that's nothing but n minus 2 factorial into sum of all digits into 1, 1, 1, n minus 1 times. Now how this formula is derived? Let's take one example and try to understand that. For that, I will take a very simple example, because it's always better to take a small numbers, a simple example, so that we can understand the concept. Then once we are able to understand that, then we can generalize it for any numbers. Okay, let's take a simple example. Suppose I say 0, 2, 0, 2, 3. These are the digits we have been given, and we have been asked to find out all 3 digit numbers. Now without the formula, how the formula is derived in the last time, let's go there and do that. What we said that we will find out all the numbers starting with 0, all the numbers starting with 2, all the numbers starting with 3. So if I start with 0, it will be 0, 2, 3, it will be 0, 3, 2. Similarly, when I start with 2, it will be 2, 0, 3, and it will be 2, 3, 0. Similarly, when I start with 3, it will be 3, 0, 2, it will be equal to 3, 2, 0. So, the sum of all these numbers, let us say, suppose we add them 320, 622, 852, 1055, 1087, 1110. I'll write down here, sum of all of them is 1110. We just verify with the formula afterwards. Now we want only 3 digit numbers, but these are not 3 digit numbers, right? These are not 3 digit numbers. So that sum I have to subtract. How much I have to subtract? Let us look at that. That's 23 plus 32, that's equal to 55. I have to subtract. Now how we know that basically total we have 1110, but we have to subtract this because these are not 3 digit numbers. So is this nothing but equal to, if I remove the 0, is it nothing but all the 2 digits formed with, it's 2 and 3. Suppose you have 2 and 3, you want to form the 2 digits, it will be only 2, 3 and 3, 2. So that is nothing but 1 subtract whatever you from the earlier formula. Earlier we had all 3 digit numbers. Now these are 2 digit numbers. That means this will become 2 digit, n minus 1 times, sum of all digits, and this will become n minus 2 factorial. Now you substitute in the formula and cross check. Here n equal to 3. So, our formula will be factorial 2 into sum of all digits, that's 2 plus 3, 5, into 3 digits, that's 111, minus. Now, next time it is n minus 2 factorial, that means 3 minus 2, 1 factorial, into sum of all digits, that's equal to 5, into. Now, this time I have to go for 1 like that only n minus 1 times. This is n. So n minus 1 is only 2. So that's equal to 10 into 1, 1, 1, 0 minus 55, which is nothing but same as our earlier answer. So we have to understand whenever the zeros are included, we don't need the number sum of the numbers which are starting with 0, because they are not 3 digit numbers. We are interested only in the 3 digit numbers. So how many numbers will be like that? Suppose first is fixed for 0, then remaining all are 2 digit numbers formed with 2 and 3. So I can write them as n minus 2 factorial into sum of all digits into 1 1 1 up to n minus 1 times. Let's take one more example so that you are clear with that. Let us take another example. Suppose we want to find out all the 4 digit numbers, using 0, 1, 2 and 3. What will be according to our formula? N equal to 4. So first we find out taking 0 also, then we will have n minus 1, that's factorial 3, into sum of all digits, that's nothing but 6, 1 plus 2 plus 3, 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6, into 1, 1, 1, n times, 4 digits it is. So 1, 1, 1, minus. Next time, I have to go 1 less than 3 factorial, that's 2 factorial, into sum of all digits again, 1, 2, 3, 6. Did you get it that why sum of all digits we are taking both the times? Because here 0 is considered, here 0 is not considered, but the sum will be same only. So that is why it's the same into, now this is, I have to go for n minus 1 times, that means n is 4. So I remove all the 3 digits. What's the meaning of this? First find out sum of all 4 digit numbers. From that subtract the sum of all 3 digit numbers which are starting with 0. So the answer will be 6 into 6 into 1111 minus 2 into 6 into 111. We can simplify that and we can find out. So 36 into 1111 minus 12 into 111. So whatever the answer comes, that's it. So now this is about how zeros are included. Now let's try to generalize this further. Saying that suppose I want sum of all r digit numbers taking n digits into consideration. That means we are saying now sum of r digit numbers taking into consideration using n digits. What's the meaning of that? Let me try to explain you. Before that, I'll just change the formula little bit. This will become now n minus 1, n minus 1, whatever we have written earlier, n minus 1. I'll just continue with the same color. That will be easy to understand. So it will be n minus 1 p r minus 1. And in the second case, where this example, it will be n minus 1 p r minus 1 and n minus 2 p r minus 2. Now this is the most generalized example. You know, what's the meaning of that? Let's try to by taking an example. The example is something like this. Suppose you want to find out sum of all 2 digit numbers you want sum of all two digit numbers by using 1, 2, 3, 4. Now in this case we can clearly see that n equal to 4, 4 digits we have been given, but we want only the 2 digit numbers, that means r equal to 2. So in that case you have to substitute n equal to 4 and r equal to 2 in this particular formula, which you can easily generalize based on our earlier discussion. It's very easy. So if you just want to understand, you can take the numbers and see, taking 1, 2, 3, 4, try to form all the two digit numbers, then you can verify that the formula is satisfied. So the point we have to understand is, when it is like three digit numbers, by giving three digits I can directly use the formula n minus 1 factorial. But you want two digit numbers using four digits or five digits, then you have to go for the formula n minus 1 p r minus 1, where n is number of digits given to you, like 1, 2, 3, 4, four digits. R is how many digits we want, how many digit numbers we want. That means we want all the digits, two digit numbers or three digit numbers, four digit numbers. If n equal to 4 and r equal to 2, so what will be the numbers, whatever we are saying they will form, let's try to understand. So suppose you are using 1, 2, 3, 4, two digit numbers will be, I start with 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Similarly, I start with 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4. If I start with 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 4. If I start with 4, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3. Now you can see that how many 1s we have, how many 2s we have, how many 3s, how many 4s. We have 3. How that 3 came? That 3 came because the logic is like this, which is very, very important. Suppose 1 is fixed, 2 slots we have to fill, we have the values 1, 2, 3, 4. First one is fixed with 1, that means the second slot can be filled by any of the 3 numbers, that means we have 3 options. But it's nothing but equal to, we have 3 options, we have to choose 1, that is nothing but 3P1. But 3P1 is nothing but n minus 1 p r minus 1. Because 1 is already fixed. It's actually npr, but 1 is fixed already. So it will become n minus 1 p r minus 1. Hope you are able to understand how that particular formula comes. This is the most general form which you can get with respect to these examples. So suppose we want sum of all r digit numbers using n digits, then the formula, wherever earlier we have n minus 1 factorial, that will become n minus 1 p r minus 1, and wherever n minus 2 we have, that will become n minus 2 p r minus 2. So just go through this and see whether it makes sense or not. If you are confused or it's not clear, do let me know. I'll try to create one. I was just trying to finish this in a hurry so that I can immediately get back to you. So please do let me know your feedback. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now.